children, today we are going to see 6th English term 2, unit 2, supplementary, Gulliver's Travels. Now let's see the characters of the story. Gulliver, he is the main character of the story. Lilliputians. Now let's start the story. Gulliver, a doctor who was going on a long voyage. Voyage means long journey. The voyage started well, but soon things changed dramatically. The ship got caught in a violent storm and was thrown off course. Violent is nothing but involving physical force intended to hurt or damage. Then it hit a rock and broke up completely. 6 of the crew members, including Gulliver, got into a small boat and rowed until they were overturned by a big wave which came up suddenly. Gulliver was a good swimmer and he managed to swim till he reached land. The coast appeared strange and lonely. Coast means near the sea. Strange means unusual or surprising. Gulliver dragged himself along the shore. Dragged means difficulty. He looked for some people or houses, but there was no sign of life. Hungry and exhausted, he fell on a patch of grass and fell into a deep sleep. Exhausted means very tired. When Gulliver woke up, he was lying on his back and the sun was in his face. When he tired to get up, he found himself unable to sit up or move at all. Terrified and puzzled, he tried to turn his head. Terrified means extreme fear. Puzzled means unable to understand. He found his arms and legs were securely tied with slender string on each side and attached to picks fixed on the ground. His hair, which was long and thick, was similarly tied down. He felt something moving along his body almost up to his chin. To his surprise, he saw a human being not 6 inches high with a bow and arrow in his hands and a quiver at his back. Arrow means a weapon consisting of a thin straight stick with a sharp point. Gulliver later learnt that these creatures were called Lilliputians. Startled by this sight, Gulliver cried out and soon managed to free his left arm. The frightened Lilliputians fired dozens of tiny arrows into his hand, face and body until he once again bowed down calmly. Frightened means afraid. Fired means discharge. Calmly means strong emotion. The Lilliputians then built a stage of Gulliver's side that was about a foot and a half tall, upon which an obviously important person stood and made a 10-minute speech to Gulliver in a language he could not understand. By now, Gulliver was really hungry. With gestures, he signaled to the little people that he wanted food and drink. Gestures means a movement of part of the body, especially a hand or the head. The Lilliputians first got Gulliver to promise to behave himself and then promised to get him some food. They soon brought baskets of meat and several loaves of bread, which he ate 3 at a time because they were so tiny. The Lilliputians also brought 2 barrels of drink which he enjoyed, even though the barrels were smaller than a glass. Gulliver was tempted as he lay on the ground to take up 50 of the small creatures in his hand and crush them. But he did not want to be pricked with arrows again, and he had promised to behave in exchange for good treatment. After he had eaten, Gulliver promptly fell asleep because his drink had a sleeping draught in it. Promptly means immediately. They then set about transporting Gulliver to the capital. They used a large platform with 22 wheels pulled by dozens of 4.5-inch horses. They somehow managed to put him on the platform and dragged Gulliver down the road to the city. Suddenly, Gulliver woke up when the vehicle stopped. Two or three curious young Lilliputians wanted to see how Gulliver looked when asleep. Curious means peculiar. They climbed up into the engine and, advancing very softly to his face, put the sharp end of their half pike into his left nostril. This tickled Gulliver's nose like a straw and made him sneeze. Tickled means lightly touch a person or a part of the body. As they started moving again, Gulliver saw that more than 100,000 Lilliputians had come out to see the strange giant. It was a carnival atmosphere, and the Lilliputians seemed to be enjoying themselves much to Gulliver's amusement. Amusement means experience of finding something funny. Finally, they arrived at the emperor's place. Emperor means ruler or king. The emperor was there to receive Gulliver. Gulliver was lodged in an old and disused temple. His leg was chained and he could only move about a little bit. After a few weeks, the Lilliputians and the emperor decided that he meant them no harm. So, Gulliver was set free to roam around Lilliput on condition that he would not harm them and would help them in whatever way he could. Gulliver agreed and was freed. He was provided with food and water. A house was built for him. Gulliver stayed with Lilliputians, helping them in many ways. Once it so happened that the neighboring kingdom of Blefuscu declared war on Lilliput. The king brought 100 ships to mount an attack. The Lilliputians ran to Gulliver for help. The emperor said, "Don't let us down now. Gulliver, we need your help." Gulliver walked into the sea. He took a long rope, tied all the 100 ships together, and dragged them in the water. Gulliver pulled the ships the whole day, going round and round until the army of Blefuscu was giddy and was no positions of fight. The king of Blefuscu came begging for peace between the two kingdoms. The emperor agreed. Gulliver was hailed as a hero and lived peacefully in Lilliput for many years. Hailed means salute. Okay children, now we came to an end of the story. So, maintain a separate notebook for English. In case of any doubt, make a note of it, which will be clarified on the day of reopening. Now, let's see the choose the correct option. First one, Gulliver managed to reach the land as he was a doctor, a swimmer, the captain. The answer is a swimmer. Second one, the coast appeared strange and lonely, simple, new. The answer is lonely. Third one, the tickled Gulliver's nose like a straw and made him cough, laugh, sneeze. The answer is sneeze. Fourth one, the king brought a dash ships to mount and attack. 50, 100, 1000. The answer is 1000. Fifth one, Gulliver was dash as a hero, called, prized, hailed. The answer is hailed. Okay children, now let's see the true or false. First one, Gulliver was the captain of the ship. The answer is true. Second one, the horses pad 4.5 inches tall. The answer is true. Third one, the war between the two kingdoms ended in peace. The answer is true. Fourth one, four of the crew members, including Gulliver, got into a small boat. The answer is false. Fifth one, Gulliver was not set free at all. The answer is false. Now, let's see the important questions and answers. First one, who was Gulliver? Gulliver was a doctor. Second one, what happened to the ship? The ship got caught in a violent storm and was thrown off course. Third one, how many of the members got into a boat? 6 crew members, including Gulliver, got into a small boat. Fourth one, how did Gulliver manage to reach the land? As he was a good swimmer, he managed to reach the land. Fifth one, where was Gulliver lodged? He was lodged in an old and disused temple. Sixth one, what did the emperor do for Gulliver? He built him a house and provided him with food and water. Seventh one, who declared war on Lilliput? The king of Blefuscu declared war on Lilliput. Okay children, now let's see the mind map of the story. Gulliver, a doctor, went on a long journey. The ship caught in a violent storm and broke. Reached the land of Lilliputians, tired and hungry, slept for a long time. When woke up, he found he was tied up. Humans not 6 inches high with bow and arrow. They gave him food and drink, received by the emperor. Gulliver lodged in an old and disused temple. Gulliver released meant no harm. Blefuscu declared war on Lilliput. Gulliver helped them to make peace, hailed as hero and lived peacefully there. Now let's see the evaluation. Children, it's time for question. Once again, you can go through the story and answer for this evaluation. Identify the character or speaker. First one, he found his arms and legs were securely tied with slender strings. Second one, we need your help. Third one, they soon brought baskets of meat and several loaves of bread. Fourth one, Don't let us down now, Gulliver.